Greetings, church. I hope that you are all well and have had a fantastic Easter season, that you have had time to rest and dig into Scripture. Do you ever feel like you just need to shout, help? Do you ever feel overwhelmed and that your life is in chaos? So take a deep breath with me and read Psalm 118:6. It says, "The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me?" This is a halal psalm, a praise psalm. It's one of six Egyptian praise psalms that were recited during the Passover and other major festivals. Worshippers would recite Psalms 113 and 114 at the beginning of the service and Psalms 115 through 118 at the end. The Egyptian halal psalms were recited to celebrate the deliverance of Israel from slavery in Egypt. This psalm is referenced by the author of Hebrews in chapter 13 when giving encouragement to early Christians as they struggled to live sacrificial Christian lives, as we also still struggle to do as year 2021 Christians. So why is this psalm so important to include in a letter to the Hebrews? It was a reminder of what we have received. During the Last Supper, which was also the Passover meal, these words would have been recited. "The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me?" Jesus was attempting to explain to his disciples that they were once again being liberated, freed from slavery, but this time death would pass over because of the final sacrifice Jesus would make. His life for ours, eternity, forever, in God's presence once again and no longer separated. God with us, us with God. When we read the account of the Last Supper in John chapters 13 through 17, we learn Jesus promised his disciples, those who love him and keep his commandments. He promises the Holy Spirit as a helper. Now, some translations of John chapter 14, verse 16 will say advocate or counselor or comforter. They all come from the Greek word paraclete, meaning with us as authority and provider. Jesus said, "And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to be with you forever." Jesus, Emmanuel, is God with us. God is holy, faultless. He will not break a promise. We can know that Emmanuel, God with us, will always keep his promises. In John 16, verse 33, Jesus goes on to say during the Last Supper, he says, "I have said these things to you that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation," he said, "but take heart, I have overcome the world." In that verse, Jesus acknowledges that the Christian life will not be easy. We will struggle. But he also promises that we will have a greater hope in the world to come. Peace is available right now in the midst of tribulation. When fear or anxiety, as we call it, tries to consume our peace and feels bigger than God's promises, let us always remember, always, that the Holy Spirit is in us. There is power over the world living right there inside of you. God in us, with us, providing authority over all of it. And though we are weak, he is not. So cast those cares on him. He can handle it, and then praise his name forever. I love you, church, and I look forward to worship in person with you and online. I love you, and I'll see you soon. Bye.